With the U.S. election approaching, African Americans living in Ghana share their opinions about the presidential race. Shop owner Jimmy Thorne watched U.S. election coverage on TV from his printing shop in Ghana's capital, Accra, sporting a scarf emblazoned with an image of Kamala Harris. As U.S. Election Day draws near, the 70-year-old is among a unique set of African-American voters, closely following the presidential race from the other side of the Atlantic. In 2019, Ghana launched a program encouraging members of the African diaspora to relocate to the West African country and reconnect with their roots. But those who have made the move permanent often feel they have a dual identity. Despite the distance, many still vote in U.S. elections. It is no secret that Thorne is one such voter. Thorne expressed concern about the consequences of a win for Republican Donald Trump for the United States and Africa.
Kamala Harris loses, America is going to change, and it's going to change drastically, and it's going to be unknown. I'm afraid of the unknown. I have no qualms about voting for Kamala Harris because of my fear of what Donald Trump might do if he's elected as president.
Not everyone supports Harris, of course. Marcus Wright, an African-American visitor to Ghana, says Trump needs another chance.
These are the opposite side of the same coin. You have a feminist movement that don't benefit black family or black nation or black anything. It's pitting a man against a woman. And then you have a blatant racist who just let you know, your agenda is not my agenda. I'm not concerned with what you need and what you want.
Jura Davis, 65, who lived in Ghana for 15 years, has her reservations about the U.S. elections.
But I think on this watch, African-American women in particular, who have been stalwarts in the election process, even when African-American women could not vote, have an opportunity to really make the difference and elect someone who is presidential in their demeanor as our head of state and who is more than qualified to be the CEO.
The Israeli parliament yesterday approved two controversial bills to ban the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestinian Refugees, UNRWA, from operating on Israeli territory and areas under Israel's control. The legislation passed on Monday risked collapsing the already fragile land distribution process at a moment when the humanitarian crisis in Gaza is worsening and Israel is under increased pressure to allow in aid.
More so, this is effectively an assault on the multilateral system. You know, all standards of UN resolutions, international court rulings, all those kind of things. I mean, this is absolutely unacceptable. And we sincerely hope that the decision will be reversed.
And Israel is under increased pressure to allow in aid supplies. According to a UNRWA spokesperson, Louis Wateridge, the agency is irreplaceable and essential in the Palestinian territories.
I mean, this is on the international community that if this moves forward, and on the Israeli authorities as members of the international community,
The ban is set to take effect in 90 days and lead to the closure of UNRWA's premises in the occupied Palestinian territory, the West Bank, including occupied East Jerusalem and Gaza, effectively paralyzing the agency's ability to fulfill its mandate as set out by the UN General Assembly in 1949.